Welcome to Army Controller Training Module. Inspired by Shri Sanjeev Mittal, IDAS, Controller General of Defense Accounts. Lyrics by Shri Sanjeev Kumar, IDAS, Additional Secretary and Financial Advisor, Ministry of Rural Development, Government of India. Presented by Principal Controller of Defense Accounts, Southwestern Command Army, Jaipur. Conception and Patronage by Shri Saroj Kumar, IDAS, Principal Controller of Defense Accounts, Southwestern Command Army, Jaipur. Chief Mentor and Reviewer, Shri Himanshu Shankar, IDAS, Integrated Financial Advisor, Southwestern Command Army, Jaipur. Directed by Dr. Bhuvnesh Kumar Verma, IDAS, Joint Controller of Defense Accounts. Assistant Directors, Shri Abhishek Sharma, IDAS, Shri Sushil Riyad, IDAS, Shri Mohan Lal Meena, IDAS, and Shri D.K. Oza, IDAS.
Defence Accounts Department comes under the Ministry of Defence with the Controller General of Defence Accounts as its head. It is one of the oldest central government departments functioning for more than 270 years. The duties of Defence Accounts Department are broadly audit, payment, accounting and financial advice to armed forces, ordnance factories, border roads, DRDO, Coast Guard, etc. The department is also responsible for making payment of pension to retired armed forces personnel, including defence civilians. The quality policy is, the Defence Accounts Department is committed to render efficient, correct and prompt accounting, payment and financial services leading to customer satisfaction. It is also committed to render efficient audit services to ensure public accountability. The mission statement of our department is, we strive to achieve excellence and professionalism in accounting and financial services and in performing audit functions.
Minimum government, maximum governance is the present government's commitment, and being part of the administration, we are mandated to fulfill this commitment. As Defence Accounts Department, we are expected to provide effective financial advice, internal audit and efficient accounting services to Ministry of Defence and its organizations, including the three services. To achieve this, we require a clear sense of responsibility at all levels, integration of the existing work procedures with a dynamically changing work environment by constantly adapting to new challenges quickly in a professional manner. For this, we have to strengthen our workforce with the required knowledge and expertise through suitably devised training programs. In this direction, I congratulate Shri Saroj Kumar, Principal Controller of Defence Accounts, Southwestern Command, for conceptualizing and creating the training module for the Army controllers for meeting the departmental training requirements. Such effort is all the more commendable since it has been undertaken during the period of COVID-19 pandemic related national lockdown and its related restrictions on office functioning and travel. I have assessed these modules and it is my opinion that the contents of each video tutorial are adequate for providing in-depth knowledge about the subject as also its practical aspects through examples and case studies. I hope this Army Controller Training Module will become a milestone in imparting departmental training online and shall further motivate other controllers to develop similar video tutorials on other topics as envisaged in the DAD Training and Development Policies 2019. Moreover, development of e-learning modules is the need of the hour for training of our officers and staff. Once again, I feel great pleasure in conveying my best wishes to all the officers and staff involved for contributing to the development of these training modules in a comprehensive and effective manner, especially in view of the fact that the entire exercise was carried out by officers and staff members of Principal CDS Southwestern Command. I hope to see more of such innovative developments in future for enhancing the training functions of our department. I would like to end with these few lines from Shri Amit Arjun Bhardwaj, a motivational expert. Kuch karna hai to datkar chal, thoda duniya se hatkar chal. लीक पर तो सभी चल लेते हैं, कभी इतिहास को पलट कर चल. मिलेगा तेरी मेहनत का फल, किसी और का ना इंतज़ार कर. कुछ करना है तो डट कर चल, थोड़ा दुनिया से हट कर चल. थैंक यू. जय हिंद.
मित्रों, आज देश ही नहीं वरन संपूर्ण विश्व एक भयंकर त्रासदी से गुजर रहा है. ऐसी स्थिति में सभी प्रकार के कार्य बुरी तरह से प्रभावित हुए हैं, फिर चाहे वो सरकारी कार्य हो अथवा गैर सरकारी कार्य. हमारे विभाग का एक महत्वपूर्ण कार्य अपने अधिकारियों व कर्मचारियों के लिए प्रशिक्षण की उचित व्यवस्था करना है, जिससे हम अपने निर्धारित कार्य को सुव्यवस्थित, दक्षता एवं गुणवत्ता पूर्ण ढंग से संचालित कर सकें. वर्तमान विश्व त्रासदी को देखते हुए आज सभी जगह सामाजिक दूरी एक अनिवार्यता हो गई है, जिससे कि हम स्वयं को तथा अपने आसपास के लोगों को संक्रमित होने से रोक सकें. इसी को दृष्टिगत रखते हुए यह सोचा गया है कि हम प्रशिक्षण में ई लर्निंग माध्यम को अपनाकर अपने अधिकारियों व कर्मचारियों को ऐसे किसी जोखिम से बचाते हुए दूरस्थ प्रशिक्षण के माध्यम से प्रशिक्षित कर सकें. रक्षा लेखा महानियंत्रक महोदय के मार्गदर्शन में ट्रेनिंग मॉड्यूल इसी सोच का परिणाम है, और इसमें हमने उन महत्वपूर्ण विषयों को समाहित किया है जो सामान्यतया कमांड पीसीडीए सीडीए के लिए अति आवश्यक हैं. हमारे अधिकारियों और कर्मचारियों ने पूरा प्रयास किया है कि गुणवत्ता पूरी तरह से बनी रहे तथा वर्तमान नियमों अधिनियमों को भी सम्मिलित करने का प्रयास किया गया है. मुझे पूर्ण विश्वास है कि यह मॉड्यूल हमारे लोगों को समुचित प्रशिक्षण प्रदान करने में सार्थक होगा, जिससे वे अपने कार्यों को कुशलता व दक्षता पूर्वक संपादित कर सकेंगे. धन्यवाद.
सर्वश्रेष्ठ हो, सर्वप्रिय हो, कार्य करें सर्वोत्तम, यही हमारा मूल मंत्र हो, यही हमारा लक्ष्य परम. सर्वश्रेष्ठ हो, सर्वप्रिय हो, कार्य करें सर्वोत्तम. एक दूजे पर गर्व करें हम, एक दूजे पर गर्व करें हम, गर्वो न हो शीश हमारा, संकट में संबल बने हम. मानवता कले आशी, मानवता कले आशीष. सर्वश्रेष्ठ हो, सर्वप्रिय हो, कार्य करें सर्वोत्तम, यही हमारा मूल मंत्र हो, यही हमारा लक्ष्य परम. सर्वश्रेष्ठ हो, सर्वप्रिय हो, कार्य करें सर्वोत्तम, यही हमारा मूल मंत्र हो, यही हमारा लक्ष्य परम.
Hello everyone, myself Vijay Kumar Mishra, working with the Office of Principal Controller of Defense Accounts, Southwestern Command, Jaipur. Today, we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is functioning of internal audit in defense. Apart from payment, accounting and financial advice functions executed by our Defense Accounts Department for Defense Services, we are required to play a very important role to enforce accountability, transparency, responsiveness and gain full utilization of the available resources by way of performing concurrent and constant internal audit of transactions, procedures and organizations operational in defense system of our country. So the internal auditors give their independent feedback to MOD on the existing state of financial affairs in various defense organizations and also in what manner the decisions are being taken under the delegated financial powers by various CFAs and organizations. Thus, it becomes necessary and mandatory for all auditors to generate value for money audit reports in all areas of defense expenditure. In this presentation, first we would try to understand the overview of audit, internal audit, and then various stages involved in reporting of audit findings. This presentation broadly covers these important areas in detail. First one is the audit and overview. Then the auditing agencies involved in audit in defense system. Then we have a look on internal and external audit, the role variations, internal audit roles, objective and scope, products of internal audit, these are local audit objections, MFIs, IARs and AAC. Further, we will see about the flow of audit objections in internal audit system. Then we can have a look on broad areas covered under internal audit. We would have some case studies, MFI and IARs, for illustrative purpose or to give better insight of the internal audit system. Brief coverage on policy papers published by our headquarters on new functional paradigm for internal audit in DAD during May 2016 will be discussed here also. Look on various e-audit initiatives in DAD. Then finally, we will talk about the settlement stages of various irregularities after the necessary corrective measures. Now, over to our next speaker, Ms. Priya Mittal, to discuss the audit, internal audit, necessity and objectives of the internal audit in detail.
Hello everyone. Let's start with the definition of audit. So, as per Institute of Chartered Accountant of India, audit is an independent function involving a continuous and critical appraisal of the functioning of an entity with a view to suggest improvements thereto and to add value and to strengthen the overall working mechanism of the organization, including risk management and internal control systems. Sometimes audit is quoted as necessary evil, but it is not so. In a broader positive perspective, audit of any organization is not only a necessary requirement, but also it attracts enormous benefits for the organization. Here we can see that audit is an excellent financial management tool with the executives. It is an assistance providing agency, a tool which helps management to assess the functioning of its internal controls. On the basis of risk audit, it also recommends measures of strengthening the working procedure and policy and also facilitates the management in this way. However, every one of us should be aware that internal audit is not a policing function, rather it is a positive support system for the overall improvement of the functioning of the organization to achieve organization's goals. There is two-tier system of audit in defense. One is external audit, which is carried out by Director General of Audit, Defense Services. Director General of Audit, Defense Services functions under the Controller and Auditor General of India. Other one is internal audit, which is carried out through a team of officials at field level. That is LAOs, RAOs, AOGEs, ALAOs, etc. and the audit sections in regional and functional controller's office. Controller's functions under Controller General of Defense Accounts, who reports to Ministry of Defense Finance. We are the part of defense internal audit functioning. Here is the broad bifurcation in duties and responsibilities of internal and external audit. In internal audit, nature and scope of audit is determined by the management, while in external audit, nature and scope of audit is governed by statute, means Its authority originates from the Indian Constitution. Article 149 of the Indian Constitution authorizes C&AG to carry out audit of union and state organizations. Article 148, 150 and 151 of the Indian Constitution are also relevant in this context. Further, internal audit is governed by the decision of the management. However, external audit is a statutory requirement and governed by the Constitution. In internal audit, it reports to the management. However, external audit reports its finding to the legislature. That is, audit reports are laid in both the Houses of Parliament. Further, internal audit is done on concurrent basis, while external audit operates through test check on part-time basis. Thus, it is also called test audit. Internal audit is very comprehensive and full-time. However, external audit is mainly done after the activities have been performed. Now, what does we mean by internal audit? Internal audit is an independent, objective, assurance and consulting activity designed to add value and improve an organization's operation. It is may therefore infer that internal audit is an integral element of any organization's ecosystem. It helps an organization to accomplish its objective by bringing a much systematic and disciplined approach to evaluate and improve the effectiveness of risk management, control and governance process. We, as an internal auditor in DAD, perform audit of transactions of defense services, which broadly covers Army, Navy, Air Force, Ordnance Factories, R&D, CSD, Coast Guard, Border Roads, Cantonment Boards, etc., with a view that organizational goals have been achieved with optimum efficiency, economy, and effectiveness. These are the basic objectives of internal audit. So these are efficient and effective utilization of organizational resources, then improvement in organization operation, then internal check and control, cost effectiveness of the expenditure, effective risk management, reporting to higher authorities, etc.
Internal audit in defense, basically in Army, is carried out at different levels. First one is the central audit, which covers pre-audit and post-audit. Then comes the local audit. In local audit of the unit formations at field level is carried out by LAOs, RAOs, AOSG, ALOs on behalf of PCDA-CDA office, which broadly covers store audit, transaction audit and public fund cash book inspections. Then comes the higher audit. Higher audit is carried out through the internal audit section of the PCDA-CDA office. This section was previously named as financial advice section. Now please have a look on the flow of audit objections in central audit. The first part is pre-audit, which means that audit before release of payments. Any deviation from the relevant rules, instructions and orders is watched, and irregularities found in the sanctions or bills are reported to the concerned units and formations for corrective actions. Then the second part is post-audit. The payments made by various units and formations from the amount withdrawn from cash requisitions, advances, etc., released by PCDA-CDA office, and details of expenditure is submitted by these units and formations to PCDA or CDA office for the post audit and booking in the relevant code heads of expenditure. Any irregularity found in the bills, vouchers submitted for post audit is reported to the concerned units and formations for the corrective actions. Now, this is the flow of audit objections observed during local audit of the units and formation by team of local audit officials, which includes LAOs, RAOs, AOGs and ALOs. The audit of stores and transactions of a unit is done concurrently half yearly by internal audit team and any deficiency or irregularity observed is brought into knowledge of the CO of the unit, and on the basis of regulatory measures taken by the unit, the objections may be considered for settlement by the LAOs or REOs. Now, second part is the CAS inspection. CAS inspection of the unit's public fund account is also carried out by the LAOs, and any irregularity found is reported for immediate action of the unit authorities. The audit findings during local audit of the units and formations by LAOs, AOGs are also intimated to internal audit section of the main office in the form of local audit completion report, LACR, and internal report of cash review, that is IRCR. IA section is responsible for taking cognizance of the serious irregularities reported during local audit. We shall further discuss the follow-up on these serious irregularities in the coming slides. Now, this is the flow of audit objections observed during higher audit. Higher audit is being conducted in the PCDA or CDA office. It includes super review, audit of sanctions, and performance audit. In a view to strengthen the functioning of the units and formations, higher audit is carried out by a team of officials at PCDA or CDA office. Sanctions issued by the CFAs at command level and below is audited by audit of sanctions group. An advance copy of any sanction issued by these CFAs should be forwarded to audit of sanctions group of PCDA or CDA office in advance with relevant documents mentioned in para 784A of DPM 2009. Super review of the units and formations is carried out by a team of officials under an IDS officer. Higher audit points observed during the review is communicated to the concerned units. Similarly, higher audit points observed during audit of sanctions and performance audit are also intimated to the executives for the corrective measures. After detailed examination of the selected qualitative higher audit points, some of the points are developed and included in internal audit report for communicating it to higher level. Now, this PPT explains about the comprehensive objection flow in internal audit system. Here, first we have a team of LAO, that is local audit team functioning at the field level. Then various audit sections in PCDA or CDA office. Then we have a methodology of super review of the units and formations by a dedicated team of officials at PCDA and CDA office. Comprehensive flow of objections in internal audit section. As we have seen that in compliance audit, objections raised by local audit, central audit, higher audit, showing the details of the irregularities quoted with the relevant rules or authority which has not been adhered to. These objections are primarily discussed with the head of the units and formations during entry and exit conference at the unit level. In case the irregularity is serious enough to highlight it to higher authorities at the command level, the same is converted into MFAI by internal audit section of the PCDA office, and MFAI is reported to GOC in C of the command by name. Important MFAI irregularities which needs attention at the higher level are converted into IAR points by office of CGDA for inclusion in internal audit report, which is reported at the level of Defense Secretary for their immediate attention.
Now, let's see the scope of internal audit. There are two types of internal audit. First one is compliance audit and the other one is performance audit. In compliance audit, we adopt criteria of compliance with the relevant rules, regulations, codes and manuals, government orders, etc. issued by government, CGDA, PCDA, CDA and the service headquarters from time to time. All transactions, expenditures, assets and liabilities are audited on this basis. And all sanctions issued by competent financial authorities are in consonance with the financial powers delegated to them. The major books which are referred to while carrying out compliance audit are General Financial Rules 2017 issued by Ministry of Finance, then Financial Regulations, Defense Procurement Manual 2009, Procurement Manual on Goods and Services, Delegation of Financial Powers 2015 and 2016, Defense Audit Code, Defense Accounts Code, various office manuals issued by CGDA, Army Local Audit Manual, MESR, etc. Compliance audit broadly includes four major areas. First is audit against provision of funds, means all expenditure and disbursements are authorized, vouched, and classified into correct code head of expenditure, and all defense receipts are brought to account under proper head. Second is audit against rules and regulations, means expenditure incurred was in conformity with the rules and orders. Third one is sanction accorded by the authorities lower than Government of India is subject to audit by Defense Accounts Department. Last one is propriety audit. This one is very important. In this type of audit, instances which in the judgment of internal auditors appear to involve infructuous expenditure or misutilization or underutilization of public money and stores are brought to the notice of the higher executive authorities, even though the accounts may be in order or no obvious irregularity has been committed at the unit or formation level. Through proprietary audit, it may be assured that every penny of taxpayers' money is gainfully utilized. In compliance audit, canons of financial propriety must be observed fully as mentioned in para 56 of Financial Regulations Part 1. Now, here are some canons of financial propriety mentioned in Financial Regulations Part 1. According to this, every public officer should exercise the same vigilance in respect of expenditure incurred from public monies as a person of ordinary prudence would exercise in respect of expenditure of his own money. The expenditure should not be prima facie more than the occasion demands. No authority should exercise its powers of sanctioning expenditure to pass an order which will be directly or indirectly to its own advantage. The amount of allowances, such as travelling allowances, granted to meet expenditure of a particular type, should be so regulated that an allowance is not on the whole a source of profit to the recipients. Then, public money should not be utilized for the benefit of a particular person or section or the community unless the amount of expenditure involved is insignificant or a claim for the amount could be enforced in a court of law or the expenditure is in pursuance of a recognized policy or custom. Then, the last one is the responsibility and accountability of every authority delegated with financial powers of procurement on government account is total and indivisible. So, these were the canons of financial propriety. The other type of audit is performance audit, which is also called efficiency cum performance audit or value for money audit. It is comprehensive review of the projects, programs, schemes, organization, etc. in terms of their goals and objectives aimed at ascertaining degree of accomplishment of three E's. First one is economy audit, means money at the disposal of higher authorities have been used wisely. Then efficiency audit, means the best expected results have been achieved from the use of available resources, that is money, man and material. Third one is effectiveness audit, means the goods and services produced and procured are satisfying the purpose envisaged.
Now we see the existing internal audit setup in DADE. Central audit is carried out by various audit sections such as stores contract, miscellaneous section, stores audit section, audit of sanctions cell, and internal audit section in a regional or functional controller's office. At the field level, various agencies are working for the concurrent review of stores and transactions along with cash inspections of the unit, which is being carried out by LAOs, AOGs, RAOs, ALOs. They work under the regional or functional PCDA or CDA. At the other hand, accounts offices attached to ordnance factories and chief internal auditor, that is CIA ordnance factories, carries out audit work in ordnance factories. Similarly, accounts offices attached to border roads carries out audit of border road projects, task forces, and POs are responsible for audit of pay and allowances of PBORs. Various deficiencies, irregularities, underutilization of stores or available resources observed during the various stages of internal audit are found as the product of internal audit, and their reporting mechanism explained in this slide. At first level, observations are raised by LAOs, RAOs, AOG during the half-yearly concurrent local audit of the units and formations. The unsettled irregularities during the discussion with the executives are converted into objections for further corrective actions. Then, omissions observed during central audit, that is during pre-audit and post-audit, are communicated to the concerned units and formations by the audit sections of the CDA or CDA office. Major financial and accounting irregularities report, that is MFAI, is an important product of internal audit, as objections of serious nature are included in this report and reported to command headquarters for further necessary remedial measures. Super review reports are also very important tool for the executives to get an overview of the systems and procedures of store and cash accounting being adopted at the unit level. Then the super review are carried out by the IDS officers designated by the PCDA or CDA. The guidelines regarding super review by IDS officers are explained in para 515 of OM part 2. On the other hand, performance audit is carried out to ascertain the effectiveness of 3 E's as discussed earlier. It is basically carried out in ordnance factories, ordnance depots, border road task forces, etc. Now comes the internal audit report prepared by the CGDA. Internal audit report is a very important product of internal audit, which is dealt at the highest level. We shall further discuss about MFAI and IAR in detail in the coming slides. Further, annual audit certificates, which is consolidated by the CGDA, depicting the actual state of financial affairs of any unit in the organization. The report is consolidated by internal audit section of the PCDA or CDA office on the basis of various facts and figures received from LAOs, AOGs, and is submitted to headquarters office for onward submission to ministry.
Now let's discuss with major financial and accounting irregularities, that is called MFAI. MFAI observed during the internal audit of the unit and formations are highlighted through MFAI report. The importance of this report may be understood as this quarterly report is submitted by PCDA, CDA directly to the GOC-in-C of the Army Command or to the head of the organization in other Department of Defense also. It is also endorsed to headquarters and test audit authorities. It is submitted in two parts, part 1 and part 2. Part 1 is for indicating fresh irregularities and part 2 for irregularities reported previously but still outstanding. Both parts are further subdivided into two sections, A and B, showing cash and stores irregularity respectively. Here we have tried to put some broad areas which are covered in MFAI report. First is deviation from specified procurement procedures, that is non-adherence to the provisions of rules and manuals related to procurement and delegation of financial powers, cases of loss of government revenue, any other overpayments, irregular payments or fraudulent payments are also highlighted into MFAI report. Non-utilization, underutilization of stores, equipments and plants and machinery, identification and utilization of slow-moving and non-moving stores. Next areas may be deterioration of stores due to long inadequate storage, defective planning and implementation of projects involving, in particular, time overrun and cost overrun, irregular maintenance or non-maintenance of unit accounts, etc. These are the major cases under which irregularities observed are included in MFAI report. This is the prescribed format for fresh cases as per Office Manual Part 2. This includes name of the unit of formation, particulars of irregularity, financial implication, period of accounts affected, irregularity when detected, and the latest position of the case. This is the prescribed format for old outstanding cases. Latest position of the case is updated on the receipt of any action taken by the unit. Quarterly MFAI report is submitted by PCDA, CDA directly to the GOC-in-C or to the head of the organization in other departments of defense. In regional controllers, copy of the report is also endorsed to CGDA, headquarters, test audit and area or sub-area commander. The objective of the MFAI report is to highlight the irregularity of any area at the highest level, so that timely remedial action may be taken not only in that particular unit level but also in other units or higher headquarters. After proper corrective action or regularization action and written reply by the unit concerned, the MFAI point may be considered for settlement by the PCDA, CDA. We in our Southwestern Command have institutionalized synergy conference at the command and core level, which have been quite helpful in resolving MFAI cases promptly.
Internal audit report, in short IAR, is the apex level report which was introduced in 1994-95 by CGDA headquarters. The half-yearly report contains important issues observed during audit which merit attention of the highest authorities of MOD and service headquarters. Cases are proposed by CDA and PCDA for inclusion in internal audit report. After due scrutiny, the cases are consolidated and report is submitted to Secretary Defense Finance and Defense Secretary. The format used in reporting internal audit cases is shown in this slide. First, we have the backdrop of the case as the case facts. Second, audit observations and follow-up details are written in second part. Then, case details with their descriptions and data are placed in IAR report. After that, audit conclusion and proposed action is written in the IER report. You may have a look on 38th internal audit report published by CGDA as a cover page. The risk analysis matrix of the cases is also tabulated for easy referencing at the very starting of the report, which shows high, medium and low risk areas and also the major, medium and minor consequences there too. Follow-up action on any IER point is taken by the concerned branches at service headquarters, and simultaneously the matter is also pursued by the originating PCDA or CDA with the concerned unit and formation. As per CGDA circular issued during July 2016, these are the competent authorities at headquarter level concerning IER. Additional CGDA is the competent authority for acceptance of individual cases proposed by any CDA or PCDA. Further, CGDA is the final authority for acceptance of the consolidated IER report issued by the CGDA and settlement of cases with the recommendation of the concerned PCDA or CDA after corrective action or regularization action taken by the executive authorities is done by the additional CGDA.
Now, we once again move to the system of internal auditing and have a look on the broad areas in internal audit. First, covering the regulatory issue, that includes cartel formation, splitting of requirements to avoid sanction of higher CFA, any undue benefit to vendors by not safeguarding government interest, whether any overpayments made, whether any irregular sanctions has been issued by the CFA, and whether any fraudulent personal claims have been proposed. Audit measures the work done on these criteria, and any irregularity deviation found is highlighted. Other major area of internal audit is to mitigate the loss of revenue to government in any form. It may be in the form of highlighting non-recovery or less recovery of government dues, non-recovery of rent and LE charges, and non-revision of recovery rates timely. The major concern is to safeguard government interest in all areas. Other area is resource management, which includes review on faulty plannings or procurement or blockage of government funds by not utilizing the available resources, any infructuous expenditure due to faulty planning and misutilization of the resources of the government. Inventory management, procedural lapses, change of purpose, misappropriation of the resources and accumulation of huge government funds without requirement are also the major areas on which we focus during the internal audit.
Now we go through some live examples of MFI cases through the case studies. First one is the infructuous expenditure on an SAG project. In this case, total synthetic surface area for the volleyball court constructed was 646 square meters as against standard size of volleyball court 162 square meters. Thus, 484 square meters synthetic area has been constructed in excess to the standard size of the ground, resulting into infructuous expenditure of around rupees 6 lakhs. Second is the regularization sanctions for provisional payments awaited since long. In the extreme circumstances, provisional payments may be released by the CFAs with the concurrence of the controllers. However, after payment, regularization sanctions were not watched for speedy regularization. On pointing out this issue through MFI at the higher channels, many outstanding provisional payment cases were regularized promptly. Third one is the non-recovery of rent and allied charges and non-recovery of demand against contractors. On being highlighted this loss of revenue issue at the command level, remarkable progress achieved in safeguarding government revenue. Fourth case is related to excess holding of oil and lubricants, which was near to expire. Thus, it is related to blockage of government money and underutilization of the available resources. So, blockage of government money to the tune of rupees 13.37 lakh was reported through the MFAI. Next point is related to non-utilization and non-disposal of 88 numbers of old generation vehicle engines assembly, thus creating a blockage of rupees 1.25 crores approximately. In this case, it was observed during the performance audit of a field ordnance depot that engine assemblies of the discarded vehicles were lying unutilized in the inventory, blocking government money for more than rupees 1.25 crores. Now we shall discuss some case studies which have been reflected in internal audit report. First case is related to loss of revenue due to vacant accommodations and avoidable payment of HRA and CILQ. In this case, vacant officer's accommodation at a military station had resulted in loss of revenue amounting to rupees 54 lakhs. Apart from loss of this revenue, rupees 1.8 crores on account of avoidable payment of HRA and CIQ was also observed. Thus, the point was reported through the IAR and further corrective actions were taken by the unit authorities. In second case, loss of revenue due to non-adjustment of interest on security deposits. Interest amount calculated on the security deposits held by electricity board in respect of MES organizations should start getting adjusted immediately from the subsequent electricity bills. However, the same was not being done. Thus, the point was reflected into IAR and further government interest were safeguarded through this IAR. Third case is related to fraudulent medical claims worth rupees 72.92 lakhs. Some of the medical claims were obtained by presenting fake payment authorities on account of medical reimbursement. On pointing out the issue in internal audit, IAR, a system of cross-checking of payment authorities was introduced. Last case study is related to irregular incorporation of escalation clauses in work contracts with less than 2 year PDC, that is probable date of completion, which has resulted in infectious payment of rupees 65.59 crores. In case work is scheduled to be completed in 2 years, no escalation clause except statutory increase should be allowed in the contracts for execution of such works. Approximate estimates for such works should be prepared accordingly. However, during audit, it was observed that the above provisions were not adhered to, resulting into infructuous payment to the contractors. Now we come to annual audit certificate, that is AAC. This is an important tool to the executives through which various audit and accounting facts and figures are reported. AAC is rendered by the CGDA annually to MOD Finance, certifying the correctness of accounts based on certificates received from the controllers. It consists 4 annexures and 13 statements with subparts. AAC report broadly consists of status of audit of the units, non-linking of CRVs, outstanding government dues, outstanding loss statements, and status of local and test audit objections. CGDA headquarters had published a policy paper on changing paradigm of internal audit in defense during 2016. According to this, in modern approach, risk-based audit approach should be implemented, which will be performance-oriented system in place of compliance audit, and system-based audit should be encouraged. In view of the modern approach, our department has also taken various e-initiatives, not only in the field of processing, payments, and accounting, but also in internal audit. Various e-initiatives have been taken by our department in internal audit system. First one is the CICP, that is Computerized Inventory Control Program. It has been implemented in Army Ordnance Corps, and system-based audit is being developed for audit of stores and accounting in ordnance units. Second is the ODOS, that is audit on online system. It is successfully working in Air Force for the store's inventory audit. Similarly, third one is the ILMS, that is Integrated Logistic Management System, which is being used in Indian Navy for the audit purposes. Fourth one is the IDEA, which is being used in ordnance factories. Chief Internal Auditor, Ordnance Factories, is auditing in various ordnance factories through IDEA, a data analysis software in automated environment. We hope more system-based audits in defense, as IT initiatives have been taken very seriously by our headquarters office. These are various level systems and committees to discuss the objections, MFI, IAR points, and find a way out to take the corrective regularization action to mitigate such recurrences in future. Local audit objections are discussed with the unit heads by LAOs, RAOs, AOGs, and ALOs during entry and exit conference at the unit level. Regular conferences at sub-area and area level with the higher executive authorities may be held by LAOs and IDS officers. At the command level, to address the various audit issues, command level synergy conference is attended by Army Commander along with senior officers and PCDA himself. Similarly, at the apex level and at service headquarters level, apex level committee functions at the level of service headquarters and CGDA to streamline various audit issues through synergy conferences with a view to make internal audit mechanism more effective and responsive, and to incorporate a risk management framework to assist Ministry of Defense in oversight. Audit Advisory Committee headed by Secretary Defense Finance and senior officers of service headquarters and MOD meets half yearly at the ministry level. This committee reports to Raksha Mantri through the Secretary Defense. At last, once again, I would like to reiterate that internal audit is for the help of the executives, as organizational goals are of utmost importance and we all are working in the same direction to accomplish the ultimate goal, that is to protect our country from enemy. Jai Hind.
अनुशासने पालिते सर्वत्र सुव्यवस्था भवति, अन्य अभावे सर्वदा अव्यवस्था प्रसरति। अर्थात अनुशासन की पालना करने में सभी जगह सुव्यवस्था या अच्छी व्यवस्था होती है, और इसके अभाव में अर्थात अनुशासन के अभाव में हमेशा अव्यवस्था फैलती है।